Welcome back to Empyrion with Respawn. Didn't realize that was going to rhyme when I said that. Anyway, so tonight, what are we going to do tonight? Tonight, we're going to make our first trip into space. Alright, so tonight, our plan is to go off planet. Haven't been off planet yet, so I'm ready to do that. So to that end, I've been kind of gathering a few supplies we're going to need. Gathered some more drill charges. Got some bullets. Why do we have bullets? I'll show you in a few. Both another drill, another multi-tool, some more work lights. Then I want to get a second... Come on. Right. Where's our little glitchy sometimes? Then I want to kind of get a second... carry some extra weaponry with me. And some extra tools. So, I know I just said I have a T2 drill. I'm going to bring an extra T1 drill, also. Next chainsaw. I have no idea what we're going to find, if I'll need a chainsaw. I haven't yet to use a filler and flatten tool, but I'm bringing one. I need multi-charges. Here's my multi-tool. Color tool. I do use it for counting stuff up, so I'm going to bring an extra one of those. Let's see. So I am not actually going to take my really good weaponry. So, unfortunately, these are one-offs. If I die and can't ever get back to them, I'll be really upset. So I don't want to risk that. So I'm just going to bring a standard projectile pistol, standard shotgun. I am going to bring this pulse rifle that I found. I do have the ability to make more, so it's not a total loss. Bring an assault rifle, an extra shotgun. This will replace it. This will be in case I lose the pulse rifle, shotgun, and an extra rocket launcher, and an extra flashlight. All this, I'll bring a little extra ammo as well. 15 millimeters for the ship guns. Don't need that. Almost all of this stuff is salvage, except for the sentry gun. I built that. I believe I built that and it was another stream, actually. I get to the point where I can't remember what I have and have not done in the streams. Food's almost ready for harvesting. So we also want... I'm gonna grab fuel. Lots of fuel. Like that much fuel. The other thing, reason I grabbed some extra base gun ammo. I don't know if you remember a few streams ago, maybe you watched it, maybe you didn't. I started doing a blueprint for a base and realized a bit off more than I could chew. So I was missing a lot of the, I was going to do this base. Started it, realized I was missing a lot of components, and had to put it on hold. Well, I've done some mining in the interim since my last stream, or my last video, so I've got everything I need. I'm going to go ahead and click start. We're going to let all this start cooking. We've got an hour. Don't worry, I won't make us wait an hour. The other thing that's worth mentioning, let me check. You know what? I don't know that I showed off the new addition to my base on my last stream. I really should go back and watch it and find out. Actually, as of this writing, I'm still encoding the streams. I haven't gotten to my last stream yet. So anyway, built a new addition so I could park my small vessel in here, so I could stop parking it outside. Did this new addition in concrete just because it was cheaper and I have way too much of it. Concrete's not my favorite, but I've realized that for one, it has fewer hit points. I realized that on this planet, that's really not an issue. Hasn't been an issue for me yet. The other thing I built, though, is a landing area for my small vessel. And I built a new small vessel. I did not record this building of the small vessel. I thought about it, and then I said, well, you know, I really want to just get this done. And I figured you'd watch me build a hover. I can build another vessel later. I'll probably stream, this probably certainly won't be my last vessel. So anyway, here's a quick tour of my small vessel. I'm going to move it inside where there's a little more light. Oops. Come on. I got stuck on something. What it's getting stuck on. Roll. Go up. Roll. I don't know what the deal is with this thing. Never had problems bringing it in the garage before. Alright, you know what we're gonna do? Forget that. We're gonna fly over to the landing pad over here. So, here's my new small vessel. I wanted something that doesn't look as good. but I wanted something with a little more utility than my last one. This was built for some extended off-planet. Turn on the lights. It's built for some extended off-planet excursions. So maybe a little overbuilt. I basically just built a freaking cargo van. The other addition I made, I realized it's kind of hard to work on the bottom of your ship, so I put some elevator blocks down here. Throw out some of the concrete, put some elevator blocks, so I can come down and actually work on the bottom of my ship. My small vessel. So, what does it got? Or what do we have? We've got two directional thrusters on each thing on the on each side of the x-axis plane. On the top, we have two directional thrusters. On the bottom, I realized that ship is a little slow to take off. So on the bottom, I actually put four directional thrusters. For armaments, I've got two Gatling guns. May be enough, may not be enough. But that's what I got. I also have lights all around. That's kind of become my thing. This game is a freaking dark game, and I think the other planets might be even worse. I also did this. Made sure I grouped everything to make it easier, so I could turn off the thrusters. Pure idle usage without the thrusters on. 4 minutes and 32 seconds. Turn off the exterior lights. Gonna run for about 452, and interior lights are not much. I do have on the sides. I have to come. Oh no, that's right. I grouped this with the exterior lights. So anyway, full fuel it'll last about that long. So I truly. Why are these floodlights? Why are these exterior lights still on? Oh, that's right. I put the floodlights on a separate group. Running lights. Right. Spotlights. There we go. That's everything off. That makes more sense. Alright. So the ship is in low power mode. It's here, but it's in low power mode. And it kind of sank down into the elevator pit a little bit. That's alright. Overall build, similar to my hover. When the ship sits on level ground, believe it or not, that ramp comes all the way down. And what have I got? O2. Lots and lots and lots of O2, and an O2 filling station. Don't know how long I'm going to be gone, but I want to be able to not have to come back for O2 anytime soon. Fridge, and another fridge. That way I can carry plenty of stock, large stock of food with me. Ammo, small ammo container, that's for the Gatling guns. More fuel tanks. Again, I want to be able to roam for decent periods of time without having to come back. Or just let it sit idle for a while. Small constructor, of course. And I did four cargo boxes. Got extra O2 in here. Extra fuel packs. About to get more extra fuel packs in here, because I'm going to stick all my extra stuff in here. Place with me. Drill, my extra multi-tool. Tier 1 drill. I do still carry a T1 drill. There are areas when I'm boring out of, say, a mining hole, I use a T2 drill. I don't care about picking up crushed rock. I have too fucking much of that. So I'll switch to the T2 drill. I'm a little more conservative on the or I'll switch to the T1 drill, that way I'm a little conservative on the T2 drill charges. Chainsaw, color pen tool, I have no idea if I'll use that. Yet to use it. Propeller tool, assault rifle, shotgun. I already picked all this stuff up. Now, rocket launcher, flashlight. I'm gonna put a little more assault rifle ammo in reserve. And a little more 50 cal ammo in reserve. I have no idea how much fighting I'll be doing, if any, on wherever I go. I truly have no idea what to expect. Full disclosure, I have been off planet once. My, shut this down. One of my buddies picked me up the other night, showed off his capital vessel, picked me up, showed me another, excuse me, sorry, something caught my throat. Showed me another planet, and I did a little, Aristarum, however you say it. Did a little mining. So it was a, actually, Let's move this back over to my base. So I can blow stuff up more quickly. Is it too big to fit through the door? Is that what the issue is? No? It fits? Pretty sure I'd fit it in here before. There we go, it's parked. I don't think it's clipped into anything. It's a little bit bigger than this hover, or than this small vessel. But like I said, it's got more utility. So anyway, we're pretty much ready to go, with the exception of I am going to load in some more food. Put that down. It's like up on the wall. No! I need to stack up on food, otherwise I think I'm good on other supplies. Check everything else out. I actually do have more harvesting. I also added another little section of grow plot. This will net me 3 more cans of vegetables, I believe. Right, that's one of each of these? Yeah. So, I'm going to harvest these, do my food harvesting, and then I'm going to take a little break, and I'll be back, and hopefully by the time I get back, the, base will be done building, and I can go drop it on a planet somewhere. Or a moon or something. I truly have no idea where we're going. When I was off planet, it was as a passenger, and I was, you know, playing around enjoying the exterior view. So, we'll, we're just gonna see what everything holds. So, I'm not gonna make you watch, or I'm not gonna record myself harvesting food and making food. You've seen me do that a dozens of times. So I'm going to pause the stream right here, and I'll be back in a little while, and we'll finally go off-planet. Alright, we're back. So everything's pretty much ready to go. I'm just going to top off my fuel tank. Get my base running while I'm gone. I should turn everything off. Base should last a good while. I've got a lot of fuel tanks here. Also, once I go off-planet, the planet should go inactive. And it basically means that resources won't be consumed. Oh, that's the last thing I wanted to get. I wanted to get just a little more of, what container is it? I'll get a little more biofuel. Just, some extra, just in case I need to use a tier 1 drill for some reason. But otherwise, I'm good to go. Unless we need some food, grab some canned meat, some canned vegetables. Those will last a while. Got a bit of a surplus of popcorn here and some baked pumpkin and take some space fries too. That should be. We'll take part of the salami as well. It should be more than enough food for me. I really truly don't know how long I'm going to be gone, but or how long we'll be off planet. I might, for all I know, I might get blown up. Like, immediately, and, have to come back home. Sorry, wrong button there. Bridge is stocked. Put some biofuel in this container. Off my O2. There we go. We're gonna let that sit there for a second. So the last thing I want to do before we leave, the last thing we need to do before we leave is, just need to put the base into low power mode, basically. So, let's see. Instructor. Not building anything, I can turn that off. Save a little bit. Core needs to stay on. interior lights, I'm going to turn off food processor, and it's not doing anything, but I'm going to turn it off. Bridges will leave on. Generator, can't turn it off. Grow lights will leave on, even though if I'm not on planet, it won't do anything. Interior lights are off. Next station, O2 storage, weapon system will leave on. There you go. Base should, in theory, run for 17 hours. That's 17 hours when somebody's not on planet. So that's, or 17 hours when somebody is on planet. When somebody's not on planet, it's running longer. And let's get underway. I'm actually kind of excited here. Let's get this thing out of here without tipping over. There we go. Alright. I will be back. You know what? There's a moon there. Let's go for it. Like I said, I'm a little excited here. It's my first time flying myself off planet. Go to the exterior view here. The distance to orbit is steadily decreasing. Only a good 37 meters. I'm slowing down. Shouldn't I be going faster? Farther, higher up I get? There should be, there we go. We're off planet. That looks like the moon over there. There's, Akua, beneath us. Apparently we're not fully out of the stratosphere yet, so let me gain a little more altitude. Ship definitely gains more speed in space, that's for sure. So, I'm gonna stop here for a second. Just take a look at things. Wow. Wow. It's hard to think that that's where my character's been for the last, I don't know, I've been playing this game now a couple weeks. It's almost a little awe-inspiring here. Almost, anyway. We're going to take a look at the map real quick. That's the moon. Sathium asteroid. So we've got some asteroids out here. Sathium. Nox small vessel, Aku space guppy. That must be another ship, obviously. There's a survival constructor supposedly out here in the middle of nowhere. Let's head towards. See if we can head towards this closest Sathium asteroid. I don't know what it's going to look like. Is that it? That big round blob that looks different from the others? I don't know. No way of knowing. No. No idea how to navigate in space. Don't know how the map works. No matter which direction I go, my ship seems to point the same direction. I guess that's what happens when you try to navigate in a 2D plane. Try to map out a 2D plane on a something that's 3D. We're just going to fly this direction. I'm watching the map in the upper right corner. Our Sathium asteroid. I have no idea if I can land on this or what. We're gonna find out. And I might just die. Die a fiery death. Try to slow down a little bit here. I don't want to just crash into it. it's big. I land on it. Maybe. I don't think there's anything to keep my vessel floating away. So I'm just gonna turn the thrusters off. Should get a lot of power back. Or not. Alright. I'm gonna get out. Hang on, I need to put my helmet back on. Jetpack's off. There we go. Okay. Now I can move around in 3D space. Excuse me. Okay. Moving's pretty normal. Move around 3D space. No, not too many gotchas there. Jetpack needs to be on, obviously. Let's see what happens. Okay. So, in true Newtonian physics, I don't know if you guys remember the first law, every action must have an equal and opposite reaction. So in theory, I fire a gun in space, I should go the opposite direction. That's obviously not happening. But that's alright. Game doesn't have to be perfect. But I've heard that there are droids out here. Don't know what they look like, don't know how to take them on. I guess it goes mine. Figure I might as well mine some Sathium. Is it Sathium or Sathium? I have no idea. Whatever. Whatever it is, I'm mining it. While I'm out here. That's part of the reason for being out here, right? I have a jetpack, so I'm not just floating away. Again, I mean, this is, if you want to talk real Newtonian physics here, firing some kind of laser beam mining weapon at a rock in the middle of space with nothing to anchor me to it, I should by all rights be floating away. Thank God for the jetpack, right? I have no idea how much of the stuff I may need. I'm just gonna keep mining until I get bored. Or until something else happens. It's interesting the way your perspective changes as you mine. Definitely have to get used to the fact that there is, in space, there is no down. 3D plane, and you can move freely about it. A little disorienting at first when you think about it. But if you don't think about it too much, then you're okay if you don't think too much. If you don't think about it too much. Where's my vessel? There it is. I've mined a good chunk of this asteroid out already. How much Sathium do I have? Ah, nice little bit. Alright. Going. It's nice to have money on the asteroids as opposed to, like, money on Akua, or Akua. You know, I'm just gonna decide how to say it. We're gonna call it Akua. I'm sure somebody in a forum will correct me at some point, or maybe somebody in the comments will correct me. But whatever, we're gonna call it Akua. Something a little bit different in Akua, where you have to worry about being able to get out of your mining pit at some point. It's really the biggest reason I keep the T1 drill around, is so that I can pull myself up out of the pit at some point, maybe. Usually, I don't think I've done too much mining on camera. lately. I think I did my my first video I did was mining. I haven't done too much of that because I realized that, you know, anybody can sit there and mine, and you probably aren't watching my videos to watch somebody else mine, unless you just really like hearing the sound of my voice. In which case, thanks. I appreciate it. But, anyway. I've seen a couple different techniques of mining. Some people just dig right in. Some people build a bowl. For the bowl works really well. Because, works really well with the T1 drill, because everything kind of floats to the bottom. Bowl. I don't bother with that. The bowl gets just as hard to get out of sometimes. Sometimes the cuts are, the mining cuts might be really deep. Other times, it might be kind of shallow and wide. But usually what I just end up doing is I start, and then I dig myself a channel towards the outside, and eventually I dig down. What I end up doing when I mine on the planet is I tend to make layers, almost fours, and then on the bottom I try to just pull up the tier one drill and just hold down the button and just press forward until I find my way out. I wonder if the whole asteroid is mineable like this. I guess yes. No dead spots. That could be really good. I don't know how valuable Sathium is. I don't know what else it's used for in this game. And by when I say what else, I should just amend that to say I don't know what it's used for. But hey, it's another mineral and it's mineable. So here I am. Get some. I think, you know what? I'm saying all this. I think it might be some power coils. Maybe. So, power coils being one of the things that's involved in a lot of advanced construction stuff, including, but not limited to, the advanced constructor, which I've yet to build, mostly because of the material cost. I have exactly 3 power coils that were salvaged from. I think I saw the drone base, maybe, that I took on? Or not the drone base, the, what was it, the space fort that I took on. I think I managed to pull them out of there. So, again, when you only have 3, and you look and you see, okay, this object takes 2 of them, you tend to be a little, cautious with them. So, 2 of them being the advanced constructor, it takes 2 power coils. So when you have to be a little, stingy with them, it's a, you tend not to use them. Same trap I fall into in a lot of RPGs. I collect stuff, I don't know if it may be valuable later, so I just end up running around with it and holding on to it, and then next thing I know, I end up with a room of rooms, and it's not actually used for anything. Or I end the game, and because I've been conservative with my health packs, I end the game, and I still have, set of health potions or health packs or what have you. Whatever healing mechanic they can use this. Let's see how much I have. I'll stop when I get to 4,000. It's not taking me very long at all to collect all this ore. And the T2 drill is a total game changer. Oh, you know what? That's a good point. What's the, what happens to the tier 1 drill? Do you just have to go catch the ore? How does that work? Stay in place? I have to float around and grab it? Yeah, wow, that sucks. Once again, the tier 2 drill, total game changer. Total game changer. Not having to, man, I can't imagine mining like this. That would be pretty miserable, actually. Glad I got the tier 2 drill. Again, for those of you that don't know, or if you haven't seen a previous game, or previous stream, previous video, tier 2 drill, the biggest advantage it has is it actually picks up the ore as you drill. Total game changer. Total game changer. Makes mining much less tedious, and it really makes it a lot faster. Truly, I think it's a good balance of the game. Other survival games, you may get something that you still have to whack at something. Yeah, you may get a tool where you have to whack at something to get some sort of ore or valuable material. But at the end of the day, it's still, you still have to go pick it up. You just get larger stacks. This is, you know, this is a nice, very nice upgrade. Not having to chase my ore down is, it's, I can't say enough good about it. Huge deal. To me, previously where it might take me, you know, 2 days and might not have cut on planet, I get it all done in a day. By days, I mean like planet days. Might have taken me 2 to 3 days. That's why I would set up an outpost base, camp out for a couple days, mine at night, or mine during the day, hang out at the base at night, maybe go back and read a book in real life. Almost my goal. And come back during the daylight where I can see more light. Something I've realized that reflects make a huge difference. Almost there. Why are you not stacking those up to 999? 8 more. Done. Or not. Oh, I've got another stack up there. Where my T2 drill was. Or tier 1 drill. Alright. I think we're done. That's enough mining for now. If you're still watching, I'm sure you're tired of watching me mine stuff. There is no gravity generator on in this thing, so it's just kind of a matter of however I put stuff. That's all my emergency stuff. I'm gonna throw my mine ore into here. So, since it's this base, I need to refill my O2, which is why I put that there. I'm gonna grab some food while I'm here. Some popcorn. Should get me, close to max food. So the real question that you should be asking yourself right now is, how do I eat popcorn when I still have my helmet on? Riddle me this, Batman. So, game's not perfect. Or we can just say it's space popcorn. Alright, where to next? Turn my thrusters on. Plenty of power. So I want to go see. I saw that one of my faction members had a ship over this way somewhere. So we're gonna go see if we can find it and check it out. It's not too hard to find. Again, it's 3D space and a 2D map, so I don't know how that's going to work. The map does change on the 3D plane. Okay. That's good. Get our exterior view here. He is on the other side of the planet. I have to end it the game. It does do a decent job at firing off the thrusters in the various directions to indicate changes in pitch and yaw and roll. It's actually, trying to see if it what thrusters it decides to fire for yaw roll. Where's this survival constructor that it says it sees? There's a glitch like that on the home. On the planet itself, where it says there's a survival constructor, and they're right near my my base, and there actually isn't one. Does this map change orientation? No. I don't know why there would be a survival constructor in the middle of space. That's what I'm wondering. That's right, I'm probably never going to find it. It's going to be super tiny. Doesn't matter. I'm going to go find this other ship. Check it out. I think that's probably it right there. So I'm undecided on whether or not I want to put more thrusters on the ship. Part of me wants to give it a little more speed. Looks like a top out at 110 meters per second in space. And then part of me doesn't want to. Is that a space station? That is a space station. Or is that a ship? Oh no. Space copy, small vessel. Actually don't know who's I don't know whose ship this is. Nobody else online right now. I might go check out their ship. Rolled around. We're gonna dock right back here on the back. Shows I'm docked. Now we're off. And you know what? I don't want my food to spoil. I'm just gonna turn the hang on. What I want? Oh yeah, thrusters. I'm just gonna turn the thrusters off for right now. Save some power. You know what? We'll turn the lights off as well. We'll leave the running lights on just so we can find it. First mode here for a minute. Have I used up a lot of fuel? Or is it just the calculator is kind of flaky? Try to get through this door? Not always easy. No, I haven't used that much fuel. Yeah, the calculator is just kind of flaky. May as well refuel while we're here. Let's see. This looks like it's probably down as far as the ship's concerned. I'm expecting the ship to have artificial gravity, so I wanna. Yep. Nope. That's enough gravity, apparently. No grav generator on this ship? That's gonna make navigating the ship interesting. Or what happens if I turn my jetpack off? Okay, there is gravity. It's the jetpack bug I've read about. Alright, that's fine. Engine room obviously. There's the warp drive, ammo containers, generator. Gravity generator. It looks like the ship may actually be constructed with, no gravity in mind, with a generator on the ceiling like that? Or what looks to be the ceiling? That's obviously the ceiling. The, stairs are angled this way. So let's see. Big hallway. Nowhere. What that's all about. Cargo area? Maybe some deck. Maybe some deco blocks go there or something? I don't know. That's the, yep, that's the hangar bay. This goes up here. Into the generator, I guess, if you need to. More fuel tanks. Alright. Two tanks. Fair enough. Let's see. Guess it's the cockpit area. There's a little optical illusion there when you came through that door. Maybe not. Maybe it just seemed like it. Again, I have no idea what this is. It's just supposed to be another random room. I don't know. Seems like a lot of wasted space in this ship. Supposed to be towards the cockpit, huh? Forge. Two forge areas, basically. Interesting. Not sure why you need that unless you've got a lot of people living on this ship. Considering the number of people that are on the server at any one time, which is usually just me, seems a little not needed. I'm not going to do the rude thing and take the ship for a flight. I think that would be a little rude to do. Jetpack. Got to turn my jetpack on. Interesting, I fell down. I fell what was down. Towards what was down. Anyway. Undock. Space station, it's on the other side of this. That's right. There it is. Apparently we own this space station, so, why am I not docking? Have our clan tag on there. Knock. NOC. Short for noclip. Which was really an inside joke. I started playing a different game with some guys that I used to play in a community with. And it's actually an inside joke kind of about me. I used to always joke about how I can't dock the space stations. That's the issue. Anyway, I used to always joke about how I used to turn on noclip, fly around noclip. One of the server admins, and so it was that was the joke about. I jump back off. There we go. Anyway, as one of the server admins, one of the jokes was that I used to always just fly around a noclip. So anyway, when we first started playing some games outside of that community, we started playing. Checking the other side. Another landing area. It works weird in artificial gravity. When we first started playing some of the games, we started playing. Not started, but, when we. Other games in that community were not survival games. So the first survival game we played together was. Oh shoot. What's the name? It's the game with the dinosaurs. Ark. Is this space? So anyway, we played Ark. And we were trying to figure out, and the ARK server was hosted by the same community that we all kind of met each other on. And so we were trying to figure out what to name our ARK server. Jokingly said we should name it Noclip. And so the name kind of stuck. So here we are. The server is actually owned by one of the guys that I played that with, and played other games together over the years as well. So apparently, when they decided to set up the server, when they set up our faction. They still call it Noclip. I find that kind of fun, actually. What ended up, what was a started as an inside joke has ended up being a pretty long running joke at this point that we keep using. Layout of this space. Got some more plants over here. Food in here? Who owns this station? I gotta ask. I'll have to ask somebody if anybody actually owns this or if it's just something somebody put in place just for grins. Or if it's a good way space. Way station. What happens if I take my helmet off? Might die here. Yep. Put my helmet back on. This goes out to what's basically more useless space. There's all this space out there. It doesn't seem to go anywhere. Unless there's a door I'm missing. No. On the outside, there's a huge spire in that direction. We'll go down some more. Explore. This is what I was saying. Where's a two? Somebody's got the O2 filled up. Another docking bay. One of the things I wish this game would add is pressurized structures. Or pressurized ships, for that matter. It'd be nice if you could, you know, get in a ship, take off your helmet, call it a day. I'm guessing that's going to be hard to model, and that's maybe why they haven't done it yet. Go to the bottom here, there's another elevator. Goes down further. This is where all the generators and fuel and everything is. Yep. Fuel tanks. Not fully fueled. Generators. We have way more generators than we need right now. But I don't know, the constructors might take a lot. The fact that none of these are grouped makes me wonder if maybe this is a later built station. Or whoever did the building. Could just be whoever did the blueprint didn't group everything either. Just because I found, have used one blueprint that did have everything grouped doesn't mean that they're all going to be that way. I gotta remember which floor to get off on. Where do I get back to my ship? That's it. Must be. I didn't name my ship. Good name it. So, since this is a station, we can't go anywhere. I'll fly over here. Yeah, just empty space. Wasted space, even. Glass. Those look to be well armored, or well armed. Just kind of empty space there. I guess on bigger servers, where you may have more people running around, it might be a decent structure to keep around. But right now, I mean, try jetpack off. Yeah. Oh no! All right. Next stop, the moon. The moon. I don't know what that was. We're gonna take a quick break. Actually, you know what? I think that might be about it for this episode. I just looked at the time. So, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Next stream, we'll hit up the moon. Next video, rather. We're going to hit up the moon. We're going to see what we can find, and we're going to finally drop this base. That should be done. Factory? Oh, yeah. Wait, where'd it go? Oh, that's right. That's how you get it. Yeah, we can drop that base. So, I think I'm going to drop it on the moon. Next time. So for now, thanks for watching. This is Respawn watching or Respawn playing Empyrion. Again, if you like my stream, like it, like the video, save it, subscribe to it. Love to have you as a subscriber. Yeah, thanks for watching.